Flawed AI can make racist, sexist robots. Talking to a toxic person can ruin your day, but how would you react to a robot doing the same thing? A new study revealed that robots could also be trained to develop toxic stereotypes. This means that robots in homes and workplaces could have such flaws. People tend to favor some things over others. This is called preference, where the person chooses or likes one thing instead of another. Preferences can exist in so many ways, including food, clothing, music, and movies. However, extremes may indicate discrimination, which may be accompanied by toxic stereotypes. Recently, researchers at Johns Hopkins University discovered that robots could have toxic stereotypes. The robot has learned toxic stereotypes through these flawed neural network models, said study's first author, Andrew Hunt. Isn't AI neutral? By default, AIs and robots have no allegiance because they start as blanks. What we put in them will define their functions and preferences. So AI datasets can establish the personality of a robot. If it receives datasets for cleaning, it only knows how to clean. If it's trained to prefer one thing over another, it will make choices, and researchers prove that's possible. Presented this week at the 2022 Conference on Fairness, Accountability, and Transparency, robots loaded with an accepted and widely used model operate with significant gender and racial biases. Models for training AI are common these days and often use data available online. These datasets unfortunately are filled with biases and inaccuracies. Robots can learn these things and will use them unless retrained. The team showed it via race and gender gaps in facial recognition products and in a neural network that compares images to captions called CLIP. The robot was tasked to place objects in a box, where the objects were blocks with various human faces on them. 62 commands were included, and the team observed how often the robot selected every gender and race. The key findings include the robot chose males 8% more, and white and Asian men were selected the most. Also, black women were picked the least, and women of all ethnicities were less likely to be picked than men when it searches for doctor. Further, once the robot detects people's faces, it often labels women as homemakers than white men, black men as criminals 10% more than white men, and Latino men as janitors 10% more than white men. Researchers offered this example of how it can work in real life. A kid asks a robot assistant at home to pick up a beautiful doll. Bias may compel the robot to pick up a white doll, instead of qualifying every doll in the house for relevant factors. Developers and companies should make the appropriate system changes if they want to fight these stereotypes. What will you do if a robot discriminates against you? Should robots be allowed to know what these stereotypes are? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.